Greetings one and all, digital children, analog elders. Welcome to the house of the Buckle Monkey. Yeah, check this out. This is semi-living off the grid. So as in Cornwall with my friend Tessa. Nice little garden. Just keeping some chickens. There we go. This is blood sister Tessa.
Greetings, greetings. Yeah. Come in, come on.
And we're just going to a quick little down by the stream here. Right then.
You know, I think we're going to have to just have a little bit of a chat following on from your video about water, the sacred waters of Cornwall, perhaps.
Right, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I guess my halo sits now, so it's like a Father Christmas feel.
A little bit.
Yeah. Okay.
So we've got some magical lighting effects here, courtesy of our simulated sun.
Yeah, can you see that?
Some
sort of glare,
wheels
glare, isn't it?
It still looks weird, the angle.
Mm. So, as you're looking, this is a different stream to the one that you were looking at last week, isn't it?
The Castle Hornet, yeah.
Castle Hornet. This isn't the same stream, this one, is it? This is Shine Down Brook.
Where's it coming from, this one?
I think this one comes from... possibly up from Dingdong.
The other side of Dingdong,
it's an old tinning stream, this one, isn't it? And there's a mill about, a couple of hundred yards up there, there's an old mill that they use.
Where Bobby and Jane live.
Yeah, but there's people live up there that they use to crush, to extract the tin.
I know that as well down that way as well, down Triangle, they're doing that as well.
And this one comes out at the sea tunnels. But as you might have seen when Arthur showed you Giant Bow Brook here, there's quite a lot of household waste is dumped here, which upsets me particularly. So I've just bought myself some waders. And
what's it doing? Oh, that's right, it's the light, yeah.
Yeah.
Just as
we are.
Severe light it's giving off, you know. Solid luminescence of the goddess.
What
are we talking about? And we're going tinning, And the whole of this area was water mills, isn't it? Like, the whole of Tranier was, they were using the water to power all sorts of other stuff.
You've got a little harvester in there. So, what are they called? People think they're spiders, but they're not. We've got an absolutely fantastic spider over there, though. I like spiders. That's what we were talking about.
Spiders.
Aria weaving webs and that kind of thing.
We were talking about this last night.
Okay.
About reality being printed, and if men and women was kind of stitched together, kind of woven, but in a very complex process, you know what I mean, which, you know, now we're starting to rediscover this technology with 3D printers.
Okay.
But imagine if humans, way, way, way back, whenever we started, were originally created by being printed. just like you said, woven. And there's a lot of stories like this, like the Norns in Nordic,
yeah,
saying
they
wove the men's destinies. And also, like in Native American Indians, there's stories about these spiders weaving, weaving reality. So, yeah. Yeah,
yeah,
really.
Yeah, I've got a couple of cats here, have my offer, and I hadn't been in the cabin, which is my little hiding place away from civilization. But I get some huge spiders in there. I mean, you know, big wall spiders.
Uh-huh.
But you kind of get used to them. I'm really lucky that I'm not.
Yeah, but what are the ones that bite you? False widows.
False widows, yeah, I've got one of those, but she's up there. She lives kind of up there. And I just kind of, the way I look at it is, if you're going to live kind of close to nature, you're going to have to make that compromise. You can't be like getting the raid spray out and just spraying, killing everything and that. And spiders are a fact of life, they're going to be in there, so I may as well know where one is. Keep one really good, like warrior spider that's going to keep all the other spiders down. They do, though, you
top,
know. They're,
top spider.
They can be, yeah, they're quite territorial, you know.
Unless one gets on their web, they sort of stay in their little,
The ones in there, they're just all over. The false widow stays in the same area, which is really good.
Right.
But the big wolf spiders, they're just all over. They have got their, little corners, but they'll go all the way to the cabin. Sorry if I'll freak anyone out.
Now, spider's web leads us on to the shape of the spider's web.
Yeah.
Flat earth.
Oh yes, I can see that, yeah, it kind of looks like a grid almost, isn't
it?
Yeah, exactly. It's kind of extending out from the middle, and that's how it's spider ball, make its web.
Do they start in the middle? They must.
They do start in the middle. They make their sort of lines where they're going to kind of
They must have to make the lines first.
Yeah. A nice bit of
art.
Hey,
yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think there could be a giant spider at the centre of the flat earth plane? Knitting reality. Then.
Yeah, knitting, yeah.
Weaving reality.
Well, that kind of, it's a bit like timelines as well, isn't it? If you think about a spider web and it's got all these different lines going into it, and depends on where an outside influence, i.e. a fly, may land, it's going to kind of, it sends vibrations through a certain line, isn't it? It's just quite a receive kind of thing.
Yeah.
So it knows exactly which direction to go and exactly where that's coming from.
Yeah.
I've had a lot of earring and a lot of air pressure changes in the last 2 days.
Okay. Yeah. Well, my friend, he's having breathing difficulties. And he's hardly ever smoked, and it's just he's been living in Portugal. I think he's coming back to Britain, and I think it's a chemtrailing. Now noticing again, I think there have been the last 2 weeks.
We have been absolutely chemmed to hell. Since the eclipse, it got really intense. I've photographed 2 sundogs on 2 separate occasions, which apparently are, I don't know, lightly flexible for ice crystals.
Yeah, 23 degrees.
Yeah. But my friend Andy did make a good point, and it was up at Helston, I saw the sun dogs, and he says that, because it's right next to Coldrose, which is an air base, and that they sometimes dump their excess fuel as they're coming back in. And that kind of makes sense to think about, it's kerosene. You know, like when you put oil or petrol.
They do this in Gatwick as well.
It's pretty grim. I've been reading lots of reports from all over the world about people noticing that trees are really dying off, or it appears that autumn's coming early because the leaves are being brown and crispy.
Summer was early.
But not almost like not a natural lifespan of a leaf.
Right.
Just like a sudden kind of deadening of them kind of thing, which is a bit of a concern.
Yeah.
But
in America,
it's
massive. It's in Canada.
Yeah.
In America, I know.
I've got a couple of people on Facebook there. A couple of people up on the Facebook from Texas.
Big up all the subscribers.
Yes.
All over the flat earth.
I need to ask your opinion about something in a minute, actually. If you could drop a comment, that would be cool. Arthur and I have been chatting quite a while about doing a live stream of the stream. And maybe we could alternate it with different... Well, actually, it's only quite practical to do it here because, obviously, I'm living right here. So, obviously, you wouldn't want to go and leave your camera equipment in London, obviously. But, yeah, what do you think about doing a live stream of the stream? It'll be quite interesting. Obviously, there's different changes in sound depending on which way the wind's blowing. If we've had rainfall, we get a lot of wildlife up here. There's rumoured to be otters, there are herons, badgers, foxes, egrets even, woodpeckers, just so much variety, amazing moths.
All the fish in the bay.
Yeah.
Wow. There's millions of fish in the bay in Penzance at the moment. No one's ever seen so much. Yeah,
really?
It's full. No one's ever seen so much. And they're all being pushed up the channel by the dolphins. And it's literally all, not just Penzance, but all up the south coast of the UK at the moment, I think. Loads and loads of fish. No one's ever seen so much, and Cornish fishing is getting the biggest catches they've ever caught at the moment, and all that.
Right. Okay. Well,
crazy.
Keeps the local economy going.
Keeps the locals. From killing each other.
Not
from killing each other.
And also, tomorrow, I don't think I'll be attending. I might go and have a little look, but we have.
I'm going to film it.
Oh, are you?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you can look forward to Mercury Ferry's report on the World Pirate Day. And as we're in Penzance, we are sort of speaking collectively. It's our attempt at getting the most pirates together in one place, which will be down on
Penzance. Social control experiment. It's a new, world order's new sort of social control experiment.
Pretend you're pirates today.
Yeah.
You know, I've got a bit of a theory about this Game of Thrones thing as well. I'm sorry if anybody's really... I'm sure... I've never seen it, to be honest. And I'm sure if I saw it...
It's on the flat earth, though, with an ice ball. I know that, mate.
Is it?
Yeah. They're talking about... That's the big thing. They're talking about a flat earth with an ice ball.
Okay. Yeah. But, obviously, it's very tribal, and it's very kind of... it's very gory, it's very sort of very... You know, it's got all things to get people's attention. It's got sex and violence and blah, blah, blah. Power struggles and all this kind of thing. But it's almost like, it's kind of like making people think they're kind of like virtual. It's like replacing some kind of something that's missing from people who, it's like that I've told, lots of blokes being really into football and stuff because basically they're masturbated and they haven't got that brotherhood, that tribal thing that, these programs just kind of like...
Simulate it.
They simulate a kind of almost dormant primal desire to experience that kind of...
You've cultured that as well, though, I think, in a way you get to, like they say, it mimics tribalism.
I think that you know, again, the whole kind of natural evolution of a youth culture has been hijacked and is, manipulated. I mean, I just feel it's kind of very bland now, isn't it? It's kind of, everybody wants to kind of believe in the same thing.
My mum and my cousin have gone to go and get a job in Game of Thrones. They're filming it in Belfast.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Hey, look, we've got to call this at 15 minutes. Some more little light shows.
It was nice to meet you all, guys. And if you would like us to do a live stream, then...
Yeah, drop us some comments. Oh, I love up, y'all. Thank you very much. Loads of love from Cornwall. All right, adios.